Hello students, good morning all of you. In last class we started stereoisomerism and we have completed the basic idea of the geometrical isomerism, the conditions to exhibit the geometrical isomerism. Okay, so generally alkenes to be exhibit geometrical isomerism, of course to exhibit the geometrical isomerism, that compound must contain the restricted rotation. Okay, that compounds must contain the restricted rotation. For suppose here in this case there is a restricted rotation, here there is a pi bond. Okay, this is a pi bond, one is a sigma bond, one is a pi bond. Let us say here between these two black balls there are the two double bonds. Okay, sorry, there are the two bonds, that means here one pi bond and one sigma bond. Here in this case there is no free rotation about the C double bond C, we can see here, because of the lateral overlapping there is no free rotation. For suppose if there is no lateral overlapping, okay, if there is no lateral overlapping, okay, here we can see in this case, here there is no double bond, here there is no double bond, there is a single bond, so it is easily rotated, it can be easily rotated. But if there is a lateral overlapping here, it cannot be rotated easily. So that's why if there is a restricted rotation, that exists in a two different forms, one is a cis isomer and other one is a trans isomer. Okay, one is a cis isomer and other one is trans isomer. Here in this case, see this one, here there is a restricted rotation about the C double bond C. Here the two similar groups on the same side, here two similar groups on the opposite side. So here these two are the cis and trans isomers. Okay, it is a cis isomer and it is a trans isomer. Here there is no interconversion, actually there is no interconversion between these two. This is isolable, this is isolable. We can separate the mixture of these two compounds, okay, because of their different properties. Here you can see the cis and trans isomers are exist because of the restricted rotation. Okay, that's it. Now here in this class let us discuss geometrical isomerism in polyenes. Okay, geometrical isomerism in polyenes. Before that, let us try to solve the these questions: the possible isomers of C4H8 and C2H2Cl. Here already we have some idea about the geometrical isomerism. Okay, which compounds are exist in a cis and trans isomers. Yeah, see this one, C4H8 means your degree of unsaturation is 1. So here that may be alkene or may be cycloalkene. Yeah, C double bond C. Okay, and another one, C double bond C, here carbon and carbon. It is a 1-butene, it is a isobutene. This is isobutene, 1-butene and isobutene. These two are the chain isomers. Now here these two are the position isomers. These are the 1-butene, this is the 2-butene. This 2-butene can be exist in a two different forms, your hydrogen methyl, a hydrogen methyl, different groups, so that can exist in a cis and trans isomer. But here this 1-butene does not exhibit the geometrical isomerism because this double bonded carbon attached to the hydrogens. Okay, two similar hydrogens. So here the each double bonded carbon must contain the different groups to exhibit the geometrical isomer. Okay, so these are the acyclic isomers. Now this is the cyclobutane and one more compound, this one. Okay, one more compound, methyl cyclopropane. So how many isomers are exist for this one? Here 1 2 3 4 5 6, total isomers 6. That means here structural plus stereoisomers, structural plus stereoisomers means structural plus geometrical isomers 6, but only structural isomers 1 2 3 4 5, only structural isomers 5, only structural isomers 5. Here including geometrical isomers 6, because this compound exists in a cis and trans form, the same connectivity but different spatial arrangement, geometrical isomers or stereo isomers. And next here coming to this one, C2H2Cl, its degree of unsaturation is 1. okay, with two carbon cyclic ring is not possible. So there is a double bond. Okay, and here there is a C double bond C. Okay, there is a C double bond C because degree of unsaturation 1 and only two carbons. Now here, this chlorine and chlorine, here hydrogen. This is 1,1 dichloro. Okay, 1,1 dichloro ethene. Next one, we can change the position. We can change the position. Here, hydrogen, chlorine, double bond. Here, chlorine, hydrogen. It is 1,2 dichloro ethene. This 1,2 dichloro ethene exists in a cis form and trans form. Cis form and trans form. So total isomers are the 3. If you count only structural isomers, 1,1 dichloroethene, 1,2 dichloroethene, only 2 isomers. Including stereoisomers, there is 3. Because this one exhibits the cis and trans isomer. Okay? Now, coming to the today topic, that is geometrical isomerism in polyenes. So let us start with the dienes actually. Here, need to be discussed the classification of the dienes. Diene means here that compound contains two double bonds. So the compounds contain two double bonds are classified into three types. Those are the cumulated dienes and the conjugated dienes and isolated dienes. Okay, cumulated dienes. Here, okay, cumulated dienes, conjugated dienes and isolated dienes. Okay, stop the video and write this one. Okay, so here, what are the cumulated dienes? If two double bonds are adjacent to each other, C double bond like this, it is a cumulated diene. Okay, it is a cumulated diene. If two double bonds are adjacent to each other, next conjugated means double bonds are alternate. Okay, double bonds are alternate. A double bond, single bond, double bond, like this. This is the conjugated dienes. Okay, next isolated dienes means here, these are not alternative. Okay, these are not alternative and not cumulated. Okay, if two double bonds are adjacent to each other, cumulated. If alternatively present, there is a conjugated dienes or alternative dienes. This is the isolated dienes. Okay, these are not alternative, not cumulative. So this is the classification of the dienes. Now here, see this one. Here, for suppose example, CH3CH double bond CH, bond CH double bond CH. It is a diene actually. This is diene. This diene exhibit geometrical isomerism or not? Okay. This diene exhibit geometrical isomerism. This diene exhibit the geometrical isomerism. Okay, here about this double bond geometrical isomerism is not possible because this carbon attached to the same hydrogens. Now here coming to this one. Here the about this double bond geometrical isomerism is exist because this carbon attached to the hydrogen and this group, hydrogen and methyl. So here the geometrical isomers are hydrogen, hydrogen, same side. Now CH3 and CH double bond CH. Okay, this is one isomer. And C double bond C, hydrogen and hydrogen. CH double bond CH2 and CH. One of the cis isomer and other one is a trans isomer. Okay, about this one not possible. About this one possible. Now, for suppose CH3 CH double bond CH, CH double bond CH and CH3. Here in this case, about this double bond geometrical isomerism possible, about this double bond geometrical isomerism also possible. Because this carbon attached to the hydrogen methyl and this carbon attached to the hydrogen and this. Okay, different. And similarly same. This carbon attached to the hydrogen methyl and this is attached to the hydrogen and different. So this one also exhibits the geometrical isomerism. Okay. So here, for this compound, how many geometrical isomers are exist? Okay, how many geometrical isomers are exist? Let us discuss in calculation of the geometrical isomers. But this compound exhibits the geometrical isomers. Okay. For suppose CH2 double bond, CH bond CH double bond. Here CH3 CH. This double bonded carbon has singular groups, so no geometrical isomerism. And this double bonded carbon has two hydrogens, so no geometrical isomerism. Okay, that's it. Now, see this one. Cumulated dienes. Cumulated dienes. And here, before that,
for the discussion of the cumulated dienes, let us discuss one tricky example.
Okay. So let us discuss one tricky example, that is a CH3CH double bond CH. Okay. CH double bond CH, bond CH double bond CH, bond CH. It is a triene. It is a conjugated triene. Because double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond. Alternatively present. Okay. Here, about this double bond geometrical isomerism possible. Because this carbon, hydrogen, methyl, and this carbon, hydrogen, and different group. Now here, about this one, geometrical isomerism is possible. Carbon attached to the different group. Now here, coming to this one. What about this double bond? Is geometrical isomerism possible across this C double bond C? Here, in this case, this is the one group, and this is one group. Actually, these two are same structurally. Okay, these two are structurally same. So here, across this double bond, geometrical isomerism must not be possible. Okay, that should not exhibit geometrical isomerism. But here, about this double bond, geometrical isomerism also exists. Okay, here you can see, for suppose, about this one, geometrical isomerism is not possible because this is carbon attached to the two hydrogens. Now in this case, this carbon attached to the this group and this one also same. On both sides, similar groups. So this double bond should not exhibit the geometrical isomerism. But across this double bond also geometrical isomerism is possible. Okay. How it is? For suppose I am writing like this here. C double bond C. Here hydrogen and hydrogen. Okay. And here C double bond C. Here hydrogen, here hydrogen. This is CH3. Now here C double bond C. Here hydrogen. This is hydrogen. And this is CH3. Okay. Here see clearly. Here what is the configuration? What is the configuration of this double bond? Hydrogen, hydrogen same side. So cis. Here hydrogen, hydrogen same side. So cis. Here, the geometrically is same. This is cis isomer and it is a cis one. A configuration about this C double bond C, cis. Configuration about this C double bond C, cis. Okay. That means here, structurally same and geometrically same. Now here, let us write one more structure. Let us write one more structure. C double bond. Yes, CH3, hydrogen and the hydrogen. The C double bond C. Here this hydrogen and the CH3 and this is the hydrogen. Yeah. Here structurally same, geometrically same. Now in this case it is a cis. Hydrogen, hydrogen same side. Here hydrogen, hydrogen opposite side. So it is a trans. Okay. Cis and trans. Here in this case structurally same. CH, CH, CH3. CH, CH, CH3. But here cis geometry but here trans geometry. Structurally same but geometrically different. Now here across this double bond geometrical isomerism is possible. Okay. Across this double bond geometrical isomerism we can say. Okay. So here in this case across this one possible. Here across this one not possible. That means here in some conditions. So based on the geometry of these two double bonds. About this C double bond C geometrical isomerism. Is possible or not. Okay. So about this C double bond C geometrical isomerism is decided based on the geometry of these two double bonds. If the already these are structurally same, If these are geometrically same, there is no geometrical isomerism across this C double bond C. If these two are different geometrically, then we can say geometrical isomerism across this C double bonds. Okay, that's it. Now it is a hydrogen hydrogen same side cis isomer. Hydrogen hydrogen trans side opposite position trans isomer. Okay, that's it. Okay. The important one, next one. Here for suppose CH2 double bond CH, bond CH, double bond CH, bond CH, double bond CH. This one do not exhibit the geometrical isomer. Across this one not possible because this carbon attached to the two hydrogens, and this one not possible, and here about this one not possible. Because about this one geometrical isomerism is possible, then we can discuss the geometrical isomerism about this double bond like this example. Okay, that's it. Okay, about this one geometrical isomerism possible or not possible. Okay, here in this case not possible, here in this case there is possibility. That's it. Okay, so that is it. And next but suppose okay, first write down this one. Yeah, next let us discuss geometrical isomerism in aline derivatives. Okay, aline means it contains two double bonds adjacent to each other, that is a cumulated diene. Okay, so here this to exhibit the geometrical isomerism, that compound must be planar. Okay, that compound must be planar. Here there is a C double bond C, and all bonding atoms in the same plane, so it is a planar. If it is a planar, similar groups on the opposite side trans. Yes, similar groups on the same side, cis isomer. But coming to the aline, this aline is non-planar compound. Okay, this aline is non-planar compound. Okay, here we can see how this aline is non-planar. Okay, you can see here. Yes. There are two double bonds. Yeah, yeah. See this one. Here already we have discussed the structure of the aline at the hybridization of organic compounds. Okay, this one. Again, this is the aline. This is the one double bond. This is one double. Okay. Now here, these two bonding atoms in the one plane. These two are in the different plane. Here above the plane, here below the plane. Here these two are on the same plane. But in case of the alkene, all atoms are present in the same plane. It is a non-planar actually. Okay. So you know that how it is non-planar. Okay. How it is non-planar. Here hydrogen C double bond, here double bond. There are hydrogen and a hydrogen. This. Okay. This is non-planar. This one is a non-planar. So no geometrical isomerism. So no geometrical isomerism. Here this carbon is a sp2, and this carbon is a sp, and this carbon is a sp. So here sp2 means remaining one hydrogen, one unhybridized orbital. Here hydrogen, this hydrogen sp2, remaining one p orbital is unhybridized. Sp means two p orbitals are unhybridized. Now these two are parallel each other, so there is a overlapping pi bond formation. Next here these two p orbitals are not parallel, those two are the perpendicular each other. Okay, those two are the perpendicular each other. So here initially after bond formation, okay, these are on the same plane actually. So before the second pi bond formation, these are on the same plane. But in this case, here one p orbital like this, and this one p orbital like this. These two are perpendicular each other. okay, these two are perpendicular each other like this. Okay, so here in this case, to get the overlapping, to form a pi bond, that must be rotated. Okay, that must be rotated. So in this rotation, that portal molecule becomes a non-planar. Okay, here in this case, you can see these two are on the one plane, these two, one above the plane, one below the plane. So totally that becomes a non-planar. So here these two are perpendicular, so CC bond rotation. So here finally this one above the plane and this one goes to the below the plane. So here pi bond formation like this. Okay, pi bond formation. Hydrogen, that's it. Okay, so arene is a non-planar. So about the non-planar compound, geometric isomerism is not possible. Okay, that's it. For suppose a CH3CH double bond CH, a CH double bond C double bond CH, CH3. About this one, geometric isomerism not possible, but about this one, geometric isomerism possible. Okay, this arene type of compound, about this cumulative diene, geometric isomerism not exist, but here about this one, geometric isomerism is possible. Okay, so totally this compound exhibits the geometrical isomerism. Okay, so now here CH3 CH double bond C double bond C double bond CH CH. Here is this compound exhibit geometric isomerism or not? Okay, here this compound exhibit the geometric isomerism. Okay, this one exhibit geometric isomerism because this compound is a planar compound. If there is a one double bond, that is a planar, and if there are the three double bonds adjacent each other, that is a planar. If there are the two double bonds adjacent each other, it is a non-planar. Okay, so here about this one, geometric isomerism possible. Here you can see the structure of this one, how it is a planar. Okay, yeah, here double bond, double bond, double bond. So you can see this is planar. Here in this case, this group and this group same, and all bonding atoms are in the same plane. Okay, all bonding atoms are in the same plane. So it is a planar. Okay, that's it. Okay, so it is a planar. Double bond, C double bond, C double bond. Here hydrogen, hydrogen, the CH3 and CH3. It is a cis isomer. Okay, it is a cis isomer. Or we can write the trans isomer. Now CH3CH double bond C double bond C double bond C. Here chlorine and chlorine. This one do not exhibit the geometric isomerism. Of course, this system is suitable, but here this chlorine chlorine same groups, so geometric isomerism is not possible. Okay, that's it. So that is the geometric isomerism in polyenes. Okay, that's it. So write down this one. So here just one more compound, one more example. CH3CH double bond CH bond C double bond. This hydrogen and this is CH. Here CH3CH double bond CH. Okay, across this one geometric isomerism possible. Already we discussed this type of example. Here in this case, this one exhibits the geometric isomerism. How about this double bond geometric isomerism is possible? Actually here this one exhibits the geometric isomerism. So you can see here CH3 C double bond C, here hydrogen, this hydrogen and double bond, here hydrogen and this is, here again here we can write this one hydrogen, this hydrogen and this is methane. These two are the structurally same. So about this level one geometric relationism must not be possible. But when it is trans and it is cis, geometric relationism about this one possible. Okay, here in this case, because different groups, here different groups, this one exhibits the geometrical isomers. Now here it is a cis or trans. It is cis or trans. For this one, cis trans nomenclature is not suitable. Okay, for this one we can give the EZ nomenclature. EZ nomenclature. Okay, about the EZ nomenclature we will discuss in next class. Okay, now here in this case about this one double bond, about this double bond geometric relation is possible because it is trans and cis. Geometrically different. Okay, structurally same but geometrically different. So when geometrically different, about this double bond we can say geometrical isomerism. Okay, that's it. I think you are somewhat familiar with the EZ configuration. Okay, if you are aware about the EZ nomenclature, here hydrogen and methyl, which one gets high priority? Methyl. Here trans and cis, cis gets high priority. If high priority groups on the same side, that is Z isomer. If a high priority groups on the different side, that is a E isomer. Okay, yes, we'll discuss. So write on this. Yeah. So next, geometrical isomerism in auxins. Okay, auxin means the compounds containing C double bond N OH group are the auxins. Okay, and this one contains one lone pair. So about this nitrogen, hybridization is sp2, one sigma bond, second sigma bond, and one lone pair sp2, and of course carbon is also sp2. So this system is a planar. The system is suitable for to exhibit the geometrical isomerism. Okay, the system is suitable to exhibit the geometrical isomerism. Okay, these are the auxins. Here in this case, as per the conditions, this carbon attached to the hydrogen methyl, different groups. So in this case, hydrogen OH same side, here in this case hydrogen OH opposite side. Okay, that planar, sp2, one lone pair planar. That means here this lone pair and this OH and this carbon are in the same plane. Okay, that's it. So hydrogen, hydrogen same side, so it is a syn isomer. Okay, it is a syn isomer. Generally for this auxins, that means here the geometrical isomerism of compounds containing other than C double bond C, generally we say syn and anti. Okay, syn and anti. Syn means here in this case, here not similar groups, but here with respect to hydrogen and OH, syn isomer. With respect to hydrogen and OH, it is anti isomer. Okay, it is an anti isomer with respect to hydrogen and OH. So generally here, if this carbon contains one hydrogen, with respect to hydrogen we should say, okay, with respect to hydrogen we should say the geometrical isomers of this compound. Hydrogen OH opposite trans, that means anti. Hydrogen OH same side, syn. Okay, next, here methyl and methyl similar groups, no geometrical isomerism. Hydrogen, hydrogen similar groups, no geometrical isomerism. Okay, next year coming to this one. This is the one type of auxin. This carbon attached to the methyl and ethyl. If there is a hydrogen, hydrogen OH same side, syn isomer. If there is no hydrogen on this carbon, now in this case we can say this is syn with respect to CH3 and OH. Or we can say this one is a anti with respect to C2H5 and OH. Whatever the name, this is the one geometrical isomer. Okay, whatever the name, syn or anti, this one is a one geometrical isomer. Now in this case it is syn with respect to ethyl and OH. It is anti with respect to CH3 and OH. Okay, here we can compare. This is a syn isomer with respect to methyl OH. It is a syn isomer with respect to ethyl OH. Okay, here with respect to ethyl OH, it is an anti. With respect to ethyl OH, it is a syn isomer. That means two different geometrical isomers. Okay, here with respect to methyl OH, syn. With respect to methyl OH, anti. Or with respect to ethyl OH, syn. This one is an anti. Okay. Now here the question is one more example let us discuss. This is a cyclic one, double bond here N OH, this one is a lone pair, this one do not exhibit the geometric license, okay, because on both side different. Or suppose we can see double bond N OH. Okay. Here in this case lone pair. Here I am writing this CH3. Now here on both side different groups. On both side different groups. So here we can write the geometrical isomers for this one. So double bond N. Lone pair, here OH, here CH3. Now in this case, this alkyl group and OH same side, this part and OH same side, and this one in this case opposite side. So it is we can say with respect to, of course this one exhibits geometrical isomers, okay, that exists in two geometrical isomers. Okay, what is the name of this isomers? Let us discuss. Okay. We can give the name based on the EZ also. Okay, based on the EZ also. But this system exhibits the geometrical isomer that exists in two different spatial arrangements. It is a one type of spatial arrangement, it is another type of spatial arrangement. Okay, that's it. Okay, next. Double bond N, OH, this lone pair. This is CH3, this one CH. This one do not exhibit, sorry. Okay, later we will discuss. Okay, that's it. Next one. Here, formation of auxins. How these auxins are produced? Actually here, these auxins are produced on reaction with carbonyl compounds on reaction with hydroxyl amine. This is hydroxyl amine. Okay, hydroxyl amine. This hydroxyl amine on reaction with carbonyl compound by loss of water molecule in the presence of acid medium. This reaction takes place in the presence of acid medium. By loss of water molecule, here we can get double bond here R nitrogen. This one OH and lone pair, like that. So these are the auxins. They are the auxins. For suppose this auxin is produced from the aldehyde. This is the aldoxin. That is the aldoxin. Okay, that is the aldoxin. Now in this case, this aldoxin exists in a syn or anti. Syn or anti. HH same side cis. Opposite side trans. Okay, that means you can write the trans isomer also. Okay, here OH. Here R, here H. Okay, syn and anti-isomers. We will get the two isomers in this reaction. Okay, this aldehyde on reaction with the hydroxyl amine. Okay, in secondary we will discuss these type of reactions, but for this time just see this one. Loss of water molecule, you get the auxin. This auxin exhibits the geometrical isomer. So in this reaction we will get the two different products, that means here two stereochemically different products. Okay, and if starting carbonyl compound is a ketone, starting carbonyl compound is a ketone, your loss of water molecule, so your RC, R double bond, N OH, this is a ketoxin, this is a ketoxin, your R dash, ketoxin. This one also exists in two forms, syn and anti. Syn and anti. Okay, that's it. So write down this one. Okay, so here the one question: which of the following carbonyl compounds produce two products on reaction with hydroxyl amine? On reaction with the hydroxyl, you can see here A is formaldehyde, B acetaldehyde, C acetone, D benzaldehyde, and benzophenone. Okay, benzophenone. F CH3. That's it. Here, which of the following carbonyl compounds produce two products on reaction with the hydroxyl? Yeah. Okay. Now see this one. Here, this one on reaction with the hydroxyl amine. So this is the product, C bond here, hydrogen, double up bond, N OH. Here, due to similar groups, this one produces only one product. Okay, only one product, no geometric isomerism. That's it. Now your methyl and hydrogen, it is the first compound of the aldehyde. Next homologous of the aldehyde is the acetaldehyde. Starting compound of the aldehyde, formaldehyde. Next homologous is the acetaldehyde. So here in this case, CH2NOH, here we can get the two isomers, double bond NOH. Here two are the difference, so this one exists in a syn and anti. So your two products are produced. Now here methyl same, only one product, no geometric isomerism for the ketoxin. Here different groups, so this one produces two products. Okay, now here in this case same, it is a benzophenone, it is a benzaldehyde, it is a benzophenone. This one also produces only one compound. Now here coming to this one, this phenyl, this is the para, this is the metatoluyl. Okay, this is a phenyl, this is metatoluyl. On both side different groups are. So this one on reaction with the hydroxyl amine produces two products. That means here H2NOH, a loss of water molecule. So here the product is double bond NOH. Okay, see, yes, it is one isomer. If OH on this side, that is another isomer. That means. So here also two products are produced. Also two products are produced. Next G. Here this one produce only one isomer. Okay. Just here loss of water molecule. That's it. This one do not exhibit the geometric isomerism. Only single product is produced. Single product is produced. Now for suppose double bond O. Okay. Here H2NOH. That is, I am writing here, Cl. Okay, here in this case C double bond Cl, NOH on both sides different. A CH2CHCl on both sides different. So here two products we can get for this reactant. Okay, that's it. So one more different structure is there, you will see in exam. Okay, that's it. Now here, another one important question, another one important concept here. You see this one, CH3CH double bond CH2CH double bond O. This one on reaction with, this one on reaction with the hydroxyl amine, how many products are produced? Okay, how many products are produced? Here you can see, this double bond is not affected, this carbonyl group is affected, so loss of water molecule, loss of water molecule. Here CH3CH
double bond C hydrogen.
Okay, CH3HH, yes, CH2CH double bond NOH and lone pair. Here about this one, geometric asymmetry is possible, so syn and anti, just two products are produced, two products are produced. Okay, of course we can think about this double bond. Here this double bond geometry is fixed, cis, it is fixed, that is given as a cis. Now here this is involved in a reaction, so after result, after completion of the reaction, that may exist in a syn and anti, syn or anti, but the configuration of this double bond in the product also same. That means here cis and syn plus cis and anti, these are the two products across this double bond cis, about this one maybe syn or anti, it means cis syn cis anti, two products are produced. Now here you can see here very interesting, CH3CH double bond CH, now CH2CH double bond O, this one on reaction with hydroxyl amine. Okay, then here CH3CH double bond CH, here CH2CH double bond N, here is the double bond, here is the double bond. Here the point is, its geometry is not fixed. Your geometry is fixed, cis. Your geometry is not given. It may be cis or trans. It may be cis or trans. So here it means it is a mixture of the cis and trans. It is a reactant. It is a reactant of the cis and trans isomers. Because the specific configuration is not mentioned, but your configuration is mentioned, cis. So here, this configuration is not changed, so that's why you will get the only two products. But in this case, configuration is not specified, so it may be cis or it may be trans. So that means here, it is a cis, it may be syn. It is a cis, it may be anti. Okay, it is trans, it may be syn. It is trans, it may be anti. Okay. That means here cis syn cis anti trans syn trans anti. So how many products are produced? Four products are produced in this reaction. Okay, in the exam the question like this, if configuration is not mentioned, then we can choose the number 4. If configuration is mentioned, we should choose the number 2. Okay, because in this case here cis syn cis anti, but here maybe cis syn cis anti trans syn trans anti, so four products are the possible. Okay, that is about the geometric isomerism in oximes. Okay, let's write down. Okay, that's it. So next, similarly, carbonyl compound CH3CH double bond N on reaction with
This is hydrazine. This is hydrazine. Again here, loss of water molecule. So your CH3C, H double bond, N, here NH2, here lower pair. It is a one isomer. Of course here H and NH2, H and NH2, anti, let us say anti plus, we can get the your hydrogen, this is CH3, this lone pair, and this one NH2. This one is a syn, hydrogen NH2 same side, syn. Here, carbonyl compounds on reaction with the hydroxyl amine will get the oxymes, aldoxymes or ketoxymes. Here carbonyl compounds on reaction with the hydrazine, those products are called as hydrazone. Those products are called as hydrazones. We'll discuss in second year also. Okay, this is a hydrazone. So hydrazones also exhibit the geometric asymmetry across C double bond C. Here different groups must be there. Okay, as is the regular rules. Okay, hydrazine. Okay, so geometric isomerism in hydrazones. For suppose here CH3CH3 double bond N, here NH2, this is the lone pair. This one do not exhibit the geometric isomerism. Okay, that's it. Now here next, geometric isomerism in azole compounds. Okay, geometric isomerism in azole compounds. What are the azole compounds? The compounds containing N double bond are the azole compounds. Okay, you see this one, PH, N double bond N, a PH. This is the lone pair, this is the lone pair. What is the hybridization of this nitrogen? SP. Phenyl-phenyl same side, so syn isomer. Syn isomer. Geometric isomerism across the N double bond N. Here these are the azo compounds. Phenyl-phenyl same side. That is azo syn isomer. This is a syn azo benzene. Syn azo benzene. Okay, next N double bond N. This is the lone pair. This is phenyl. And this is phenyl. This is the lone pair. That is anti isomer. That is the anti azo benzene. Okay, that's it. Geometric isomerism in oxymes, hydrazones and azo compounds. Okay, that's it. Right on.